In March, the Federal Reserve signaled it would do practically anything to help the American economy fend off a recession.
So the Fed has two main roles. The one we most think about is of monetary policy, which basically means raising interest rates and lowering interest rates to try and keep the economy on an even keel. The other role it has is what we would call its lender of last resort role. And in fact, that is the role for which most central banks, including the Fed, were originally created.
The Fed says it will use its full range of tools to support the U.S. economy during the coronavirus pandemic. Here are the tools. Tool number one, interest rates. On March 15th, the central bank dropped its interest rate target.
Today, we reduced the target range for our policy interest rate by 1 percentage point, bringing it close to zero, and said that we expect to maintain the rate at this level until we're confident that the economy has weathered recent events.
Historically, the Fed has cut interest rates in an effort to stimulate growth, but that's only one of its tools.
In most recessions in the past, the Fed has had to lower interest rates by an average of 5 percentage points to turn things around and get the economy growing again. It came into this crisis with interest rates already very low at only around 1.5 percentage points, and it's already cut them to zero. And so it is effectively out of ammunition.
Having lost the use of its main tool, here are some of the other tools the Fed can use. Tool number two, government bonds. On Monday, March 23rd, the Fed said it would buy $375 billion in Treasury securities and $250 billion in mortgage-backed securities in just 1 week. The Fed has done this before, in 2008. Between then and 2014, the central bank's asset sheet grew. Then spending plateaued, and the Fed started to wind down its balance sheet. But the Fed's buying in March leaves the bank with more than $4.5 trillion in assets. The central bank has said that moving forward, the purchases of government securities are essentially unlimited.
That tends to lower long-term interest rates, and that brings down things like mortgage rates directly. So it has been buying bonds. The only problem is that bond rates are down below 1%, and so there isn't a lot of juice it can get to the economy by pushing those down further. So right now, the Fed's monetary policy role is largely out of ammunition. However, the Fed can do a lot through the lender of last resort role, and in fact, we have seen it do a lot.
As lender of last resort, the Fed can make more money available to the financial system to make sure that it has cash to operate smoothly. In mid-March, the Fed made $1.5 trillion available in a bid to prevent unusual disruptions in the repo market. In these transactions, the Fed lends cash and accepts government bonds or mortgage-backed securities as collateral. Financial institutions can use the money for a variety of short-term operations, all of which are necessary for bond markets to operate normally. You can think of this cash injection as grease for the gears that keep the financial system humming.
Now, typically, bond dealers do not need a lot of help from the Federal Reserve. But in stressful times, they, like a lot of other big companies, find it's difficult to find someone to lend them money. And so the Fed steps in and lends them the money. And it's important that it do so, because if it didn't, you would see long-term interest rates, including on your mortgages, going up a lot.
Tool number four, discount window lending. In March, the Fed eased the rules for accessing its channel to lend cash directly to commercial banks. Commercial banks typically finance loans with cash they get from deposits and private lenders. But if those sources aren't available, they can, in a pinch, borrow from the Fed.
The way the Fed lends to banks is it basically asks them to come to its so-called discount window.
This interest rate is typically higher than the federal funds target. That encourages banks to borrow from each other and to not rely on the Fed. But on March 16th, the Fed lowered the discount rate to 0.25%, which is near the upper range of the federal funds target.
If banks are worried about people thinking they're weak, they're not going to go to the discount window even if they need the money, because there's a stigma attached to it, you know? So what the Fed wants to do now is, hey, we're really worried about the economy. Come to our discount window and borrow. Please don't worry about stigma. And just to make sure that you don't have to worry about stigma, we're actually going to lower the rate on discount window loans to roughly the same rate you would have to pay out in the regular markets. And that's what they've done.
Tool number five, commercial paper. On March 17th, the Fed relaunched its commercial paper funding facility. This facility will help the Fed lend cash directly to businesses. That money is then used for day-to-day business operations, like payroll.
So the Fed never saw itself as being the main source of funding for private enterprise. It always wanted the economy to primarily be a market-based economy where private companies would borrow from private lenders. The only reason that it's stepping in to play this role is because we're going through an economic crisis. If these private firms cannot get funding from their usual place, there ought to be a way to get it from the Fed.
Tool number six, swap lines. The Fed can also send money abroad to backstop foreign central banks.
So the dollar is a very special currency. Companies and banks and investors who don't do business in the United States all agree to do business in dollars because it's kind of like the lingua franca of currencies. However, when you have a crisis, this causes a bit of a vulnerability. So at times like this, the Fed sees that part of its role as lender of last resort is to lend to the rest of the world.
In March 2020, the Fed ramped up a program that could make more U.S. dollars available overseas at near zero interest rates.
And these loans that the Fed makes to other central banks are called swap lines.
In March, the Fed extended swap lines to several banks across the globe.
If the world needs dollars, the Fed will print those dollars and it will lend them those dollars. It's not in the interest of the United States that companies and all our trading partners go out of business, because that will ultimately not just hurt their economies, it will hurt our economy, because we rely on them as customers and rely on them as suppliers.
Though the Fed has exhausted its monetary tools, it continues to work to backstop financial markets.
They're trying to ensure that on top of this health crisis and economic crisis, we do not also have a financial crisis.